Alright, welcome back. This is part two of Hades, still in early access, but closely coming upon the official release date for the game. As I said in the last part, we're heading into our next escape attempt, which is going to be, once again, starting in Tartarus, and seeing just how far we can get. Thunder. Is that... Now, unlike the first run, every run in Hades will start with a random boon or item appearing here. It could be of Daedalus's hammer for weapon upgrades, or a boon of the gods.
Is this really him? Okay. In the name of Hades, Olympus, I accept this message.
Greetings there, young man. Look, your father's always been rather difficult, and he's not so much as called in quite some time. You'll have a better home where you belong, here on Olympus. And to help you on your journey, have my blessing.
So Zeus's boons all focus around lightning. So, you know, the dash will cause lightning to strike nearby foes. The lightning emits, or attack emits chain lightning. Cast is a burst of chain lightning like that. I usually go with the thunder dash or the electric shots. I'm gonna go with thunder dash for this one because you see you dash them by somebody, and just zap them. Zeus's basic perks are very much, they aren't my favorite. But they do well when it comes to crowd control in a way.
Composed of such innumerable, ever-shifting, interlocking chambers, the underworld of Lord Hades all but guarantees the dead shall there remain until the end of time.
Good thing I'm not dead.
And before we move on, just notice that the master volume is a bit low. So I want to turn that up so you all can hear the beautiful noises of the underworld's denizens getting killed again, and again, and again. But thankfully after the first run, things do get a little bit more consistent when it comes to how things happen. Because the first run, the tutorial run, is meant to be a little bit difficult and not meant to really pull any punches because you must die before anything else. But from here on out, it will become a little bit more consistent and, I guess in a sense, easier, so long as you have wits about you. This symbol here, the trident, is none other than Lord Poseidon, god of the sea. So let's see what one of, Hades' brothers has to say.
Crashing waves, a trident. It's Uncle Number Two. It's got to be. Then, in the name of Hades, Olympus, I accept this message.
Hoy there, little Hades. You recognize your uncle, do you not? We've a lot of catching up to do, but first things first. You get yourself out of that dour underworld. As for me, I'll see if I can stir things up a bit to cover your advance.
Poseidon probably has my second or third favorite form of boons. His attacks do a lot with knocking foes away, like a rush of water.
The power of the seas should be of help.
And definitely when you get to his stronger abilities, they are fantastic. If we get to calls in this episode, his is one of my favorites amongst a few others. Yeah, the absolute unlimited customizing nature of this game is definitely one of those things that keeps you coming back to it time after time again. Like I did, I wouldn't have put in 129 escape efforts on my primary save file if it wasn't for this game being that darn good. And also for the fact that the game is still in early access at this point and the real ending isn't out yet. So gain a little bit of health from that one perk I got. And then this one, if I beat this level, or beat this encounter, ow, I will gain a centaur heart, which will help increase my maximum HP. But of course they have to throw, armored brutes at me. Because, big old armor guys that deal mass amounts of damage, that's not annoying enough. Witches are fine.
Out of my sight.
It's the brutes that are a pain.
All set.
Let's get some of that. So that was a natural thing. I tried to open the codex. We don't have that yet. I think the name of those enemies, the floating skulls, are in fact numbskulls, which I just find very funny. Let's get some more darkness. Okay, so we have a choice. We can go to Charon's shop, which I can probably only afford a little bit of health. Or we can go to this room, which this symbol means is going to be more elite enemies and just a little bit tougher, but means greater reward. And I definitely want a good reward from Athena.
Let's go, lads. I'm fading.
Ow. That hurt a lot. Definitely a tip with these guys is that just focus on one of them, but if you see them throwing bombs, just immediately dash away and just get out of dodge. Because it's not worth trying to hang around them. And when they die, they will most commonly drop bombs where they died. So also, get out of dodge. Like that. Come on, I can do it. Dash away!
Whew! Anyone else?
Oh, Zagreus. Your recent battles evidently haven't gone as hoped. Nevertheless, always strive onward while you still draw breath.
Alright, so now we have a stronger cast and the special. I'm going to take the special, just because that's going to be that little bit more useful. So that symbol there means you have an encounter, not so much an enemy or a shop, but these lovely people. Say hello to Sisyphus.
Hey, Princess. Must look like I'm slacking off with the old boulder here, but I was just getting back on my feet. The Fury Sisters don't often leave me be. Where'd they go, anyway? And, what are you doing here?
Just out on a little stroll is all. Do me a favor, though. You see the Fury Sisters, let them know I was headed down the way I came from, will you?
Oh, I'll let them know, all right. I hear you loud and clear, Your Highness. I'll just go about my business now, and you take care.
So when you encounter Sisyphus, he will give you a choice of three items. Something to heal you, darkness for your upgrades, or Charon's obol, coins, for purchasing items. I'm gonna take some health.
Thank you, mate.
Yeah, so there's one of these kind of people in each of the first three levels of Tartarus, Asphodel, and Elysium. We'll get to them when we get to them. Yes, Sisyphus is one of my favorites because he has this boulder here, which you can see the face in. And there are some things that do happen in conversations where Boldy has responses. And it's just funny. Yeah, definitely some healing is nice there. And
more witches.
In most RPGs, don't see notice some healing. Another nice thing is that these traps can be triggered not to just harm you, but to harm your enemies. Which is fantastic because that just alleviates some of the danger from you and potentially getting caught in the crossfire. Key to weapon, key to more upgrades in the Mirror of Night. All those good kind of things.
Oh no.
Yeah, great.
You really think you can get out of here?
So here is a Hades challenge room. You will throw relentless enemies at you for 45 seconds, and your simple goal is to survive. You don't get out of it early. You can't cheat your way out of it by doing something else. It is simply survive. Now one of the chips could be just to simply run. But at that point there's going to be way too many enemies on screen and that's going to be even worse. So really just pick them off as you choose, but do keep on the move. Staying stagnant is not exactly the best option because you will be found. There is no place to hide really. At this point, 3, 2, 1, and they're gone. Phew.
What's that?
Get a little bit more health there. Let's go for some darkness. Work towards those upgrades. And the game does do a good job, even at this stage of your progression, to make you feel pretty awesome and like you are still powerful, even though you are still learning and gaining power. It's not like some games where they give you all the power at once and then strip you back just to make you feel like you're powerless. You do have power, you just don't have that much of it. But it's still enough to stand up to the denizens of hell. Alright, got some darkness. And now we have Palms of Power or Charon's Shop. We're gonna go to the shop. We'll probably find one there. And that wasn't the shop, that was just... That was an icon just for more money. Hopefully we get the shop after this, because then we can actually buy something nice. Whew. Got rid of those. And that's it. 100 coins, there's Charon's shop. And now we have 256 coins to go spend as we please. So, we'll buy something from Zeus.
See, the people of the underworld has found the means to reach you with my blessing, nephew. Such strange alliances we forge these days.
And we'll take Double Strike.
The Thunder God's might.
Now, I think getting a Palm of Power will be the better thing to do, because a stronger special is not scoffed at. And what do you have to say about this, Charon?
To say, you are a sight for sore eyes there, Charon. So, looks like you're selling. Is that it? You come to help me out? Brilliant.
Charon, a Chthonic god of few words and fewer syllables.
I'm here, Meg.
Ever stubborn, aren't you? Maybe my whip might make you reconsider whatever it is that you're attempting here.
Your whip's not been all that persuasive in the past.
Maybe persistence will pay off for both of us. Come then.
So if it isn't clear, Alethera, Megara, and Zagreus have a past. Hopefully I can be a little bit more careful in this attempt and hopefully either defeat her or at least get her to phase two. Let's see, that's phase two there. Away from those, get away from those. And there's the first use of Death Defied. So you see, I was supposed to die there, and I didn't. Which means I can live to fight another day. Yeah, whenever Megara goes into these area of effect attacks, just run. It's not worth trying to stand around and fight. Ow. Oh dear. This is not looking good for me. Nope. She got me. Man. I was doing okay on that one, but definitely still not powerful enough to get past her.
Cheers for that, Meg.
Brush off the hair, moving forward.
I'm up. Oh, wow, so Megara herself got you last time. That must have been intense. She's fast and strong and beautiful. And, anyway, I hope the fates are nicer to you next time.
Yeah, I hope so too.
So, Hypnos is the one that keeps track of all the dead coming into hell. Well, at least he tries to. He's usually asleep at the wheel.
Someone's at the desk next to the throne.
Keep at it, lad. I've known great men throughout my life, and I can always tell when someone's better than their circumstances. Fight like I'd fight out there.
I'll give them hell as you once did, Achilles.
though doubtless many of the Shades who stand against me first arrived in Tartarus because of you.
It's also cool that you can see these groups of Shades gathering around. You can listen to them and find out how they died. This one says, "I told you I should have gone to a physician." And then died. So let's see what Hades has to say.
Who's that sniveling Shade to your immediate left there, Father? Already found someone new to do the busy work. And here I thought I was utterly indispensable.
That Shade boy is my newly designated contractor. One whose responsibility is to work on this house. Though who shall pay for everything my subjects here demand, I do not know.
You're trying to guilt me into funding the exorbitant furnishings you desire.
Perhaps once we are finished with repairs for all the carnage you have sown throughout my realm, then we might finally have time for all the needed renovations that have piled up.
Nice.
What about you, Cerberus? What do you have to say? Work.
How are you holding up, boy? Eating well lately? All three mouths full and happy?
Each terrifying maw of the infernal watchdog Cerberus responds affirmatively, one after the next, as if to reassure the ever-doubting prince.
Oh yeah. Need to pet the dog.
Everybody knows exactly how to give you pets and live to tell of it, right, boy?
Next.
So now we can talk to the house contractor.
Some sort of special offer for me, my good Shade.
So the house contractor, as it says, riches buried underneath the earth are innumerable as the souls of the dead, and these crystals, or treasures, or gems, are used to make decorations and new things around the House of Hades. From things in your bedchambers, to music, to the first thing you get, which is work orders for the fountain chambers.
Work authorized. A fountain chamber in the depths of Tartarus sounds like an excellent idea.
They are. Because those fountains, as it says, restore some health amongst the gloom. Because they're the only way to get healing besides food. Or other perks.
What once was a small lounging area within the House of Hades now is sealed off in utter shambles since the multi-headed Cerberus tore the space apart, mourning the missing prince.
Cerberus destroyed the lounge again.
Darkness guides you, child. You have outgrown this house. Of that I am now certain. Should you return again here, I shall keep you safe.
I won't forget you, Nyx, I swear it.
Once again, Nyx being as supportive as ever, with me trying to, or Zagreus, trying to escape. Let's upgrade some perks here, add one more to Chthonic Vitality, and why not another to Shadow Presence.
Felt that, I think.
Nothing much else to do in the room, so let's move on to the courtyard and see what Skelly has to say.
Hey pal, watch where you throw those bloodstone things of yours. You drop them, you go pick them up, you understand? But if somebody gives you grief, you got my permission to chuck one right in his eye.
I'll just aim generally for the midsection, since the eyes are a lot harder to hit in my experience.
Yep, those bloodstones. Is that. They'll be stuck in them for some time until they either drop out or you beat it out of them. Like that. Now, if I can get one more key, I will be able to unlock the Shield of Chaos, which will be probably the next weapon I'll go with because that's one of my favorites. Granted, unfortunately, I won't be able to unlock the Aspect of Zeus, but aspects are definitely a thing that come a little bit later in the game once you figure them out. Same with trinkets and keepsakes. These will be unlocked in time, and they are all fantastic alongside these secret stashes. Yeah, the game has just so much, and I love it. So we're going to end this episode here by, once again,
the Chambers of Tartarus have probably all rearranged themselves by now.
Looking out to Tartarus, and dreaming of escaping up to the surface. So thank you all for watching this second part of Hades. Next time we're back, we're going to head out on another escape attempt, and just figure out more and more about this wonderful little area that's known as Hell. But thank you all for watching. My name is Alex. This is Arms Up Gaming. If you don't mind, drop a like and a subscribe down in the, well, down below. And if you want to, leave a comment for anything that you might want me to know or just want to generally comment on the series in general. I'm open to talking. Don't mind it. But yeah, thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for the next episode, and I will see you all in the next video. Take it easy, everyone.